GRDC harvester setup guide is designed to help you maximise the capacity of your harvester and minimise losses. Hopefully the guide provides you with some tips and tricks to improve your harvesting performance. As the old adage goes, if you can't measure it, you can't manage it. That's certainly the case when it comes to harvester losses. We need to be able to measure the losses coming out of the harvester so we can make improvements and get the most from the machine. Accurate loss measurement is a critical first step to establishing current losses. So you can make adjustments and quantify their benefit. Harvest loss sensors are really helpful for visualising losses or alerting operators to changes in loss conditions. However, harvest loss measurement to calibrate the sensors is critical for establishing their accuracy. Without measuring, you could still be accepting significant losses. Losses through the harvester have a number of potential impacts, the first of which is obviously lost profitability. Any grain we throw out the back of the machine is money that we would otherwise have in our pockets. The other is the opportunity to capture and manage weed seeds. If we're getting those coming through the chaff stream, we can actually do something about it. And the third is that high losses can sometimes provide a food source for mice, and that can create its own issues. It's important to understand when we should actually be taking measurements during harvest. Obviously, at the start of harvest is a critical time. Measure losses then. We should also think about the start of the day and early afternoon when conditions might change. And then, of course, into the afternoon and evening, where again, threshing conditions might get tougher. There are a number of tools that we can use to measure losses. That could be as simple as the floor mats out of your ute, some trays that you might have gotten out of the kitchen, or some drop trays that we use on the back of the harvester. Anything that has a known area is what we're looking for. There are a few places we need to look specifically for losses. The harvester front is one area. The other area we might get losses is over the sieves and through the rotor at the back of the machine. It's important to remember that when we're measuring losses from the machine, we're measuring in the mode of harvest. That is, if we're doing a full chop and spread, then we've got the machine set up that way. This ensures that airflow through the machine doesn't change and the losses we're measuring are representative of what would happen when we're harvesting. Once we've captured the material in the tray, we need to remove the material other than grain so we can measure and weigh the grain that's left in the pan. This is then used to calculate the losses from the machine. If we're implementing a harvest weed seed control strategy, it can make loss measurement a little more tricky. If we have a Redicop SCU seed terminator or IHSD, consult your manufacturer for the best way to measure losses. If you have other weed seed control strategies, for example, chaff carts, chaff lining, or chaff decks, measurement of losses is a little more simple. Once a loss has been captured and measured, it needs to be quantified. And to do that, we can use a range of calculators. Follow the link to go to the GRDC harvest loss calculator, or you can manually crunch the numbers yourself, but it is a little bit tricky.
So we've got our sample that we've got out of our boxes. So once we've analysed our sample to see what our losses are like, we need to go and have a look at our cracked grain. So I've got this little box here. So you can see I've got all my grain sitting here at the top. Through this box here, we've got all different size screens. So we call this a shaker box. So I'll give that a shake. You can see all the grain is falling through. So as we can see here, that's our good grain sitting there. So that's our losses that we've got out of the machine. Then we've got our smaller grain. And right at the bottom here, we can see some cracked grain. So now we need to go and see that cracked grain, where that is from. Cracked grain is something that we overlook quite a fair bit because the cracked grain, we don't pay any attention to it, but that's also a damaged grain. That's a grain that we are losing out of our machine. So we need to go and chase that up where that is from. So we're going to start looking at where that cracked grain is from. So the first place where we can go and start looking is at our feed house. So when our feed house slat chain had got too much play in it, the grain will be squashed between the chain and the feed house floor. So here's the adjustment that we can go and make sure that we've got that feed house nice and tight. The second place where we can go and have a look at is our feed accelerator. If your feed accelerator is running too fast, that can also cause some cracked grain. So we need to go and make sure that that is running at the right speed. Another spot where we can go and have a look for our cracked grain is here in our threshing area of our machines. So there we need to go and have a look. So we've got our correct concave setup, we've got the correct rotor speed, and we've got the right concave gap set for the crops that we are harvesting. Another good place to go and have a look for our cracked grain is at our bottom sieve. So when our bottom sieve is too tight, we've adjusted it too small for the grain to go through, there's a lot of grain that will fall back into our repeats. Once it falls back into our repeats, it goes either back to our threshing system or it goes back to our re-threshing system. So when it goes back to our threshing or re-threshing system, we've got a chance of cracking that grain that we need to look out for.
So as you can see, measuring and quantifying your losses is absolutely essential. That small investment in time could save us thousands of dollars worth of grain that we might lose through the machine. It's important to remember that in some scenarios, for example, different times of the day, conditions can change. So benchmark those losses around those conditions. And lastly, use those loss numbers to calibrate your loss sensors so you know where your machine's at during harvest.